Hi friends, today we will study about cavitation. So, cavitation includes the formation of vapor bubbles of the flowing liquid and collapsing of the vapor bubbles. And this is applicable to any hydraulic circuit. So, in a hydraulic circuit, if the pressure is lower than the atmospheric pressure at some part or region of flow in that circuit, then this minimum pressure should not fall below the vapor pressure or equal to vapor pressure. So, because if the pressure falls below the vapor pressure or if the pressure becomes equal to vapor pressure, then the liquid starts boiling, which results in the formation of liquid pockets. And this stops the flow. So then these vapors or these bubbles or pockets are carried away by the liquid to a high pressure region where these vapors get condensed and this get collapsed or burst, which leads to the formation of cavities, and the liquid from the surrounding zone rushes into fill up these cavities and which in turn damages the wall of the tube. So cavitation is defined as the phenomenon of formation of vapor bubbles of a flowing liquid in a region where the pressure of the liquid falls below its vapor pressure and the sudden collapsing of these vapor bubbles in a region of higher pressure. So when the vapor bubbles get collapsed, the metallic surfaces is subjected to high pressure, which causes pitting action on the surface. Thus, cavities are formed on the metallic surface. So this is cavitation. So at the minimum pressure section of the hydraulic circuit must be checked so that the pressure at this point should not fall below or equal to the vapor pressure. So pressure of the flowing liquid, should not be allowed to fall below or equal to its vapor pressure. So if it falls below the vapor pressure, the liquid starts boiling, so the liquid pockets are being formed, which in turn is being carried to a high pressure region where it gets collapsed and hence it damages the tube. And the effects of cavitation are the metallic surfaces are damaged and cavities are formed on the surfaces. Then due to sudden collapse of vapor bubble, considerable noise and vibrations are produced. Then the efficiency of the turbine decreases due to cavitation because the force exerted by water on the turbine blade decreases and the work done by water or output horsepower becomes less and hence efficiency decreases. And the hydraulic machines subjected to cavitation are reaction turbines and centrifugal pumps. In reaction turbines, the cavitation occurs at the outlet of the runner or at the inlet of the draft tube where the pressure is considerably reduced. And due to cavitation, the metal of the runner vanes and draft tube is gradually eaten away, and which results in lowering the efficiency of the turbine. So there will be sudden drop in efficiency due to cavitation in case of reaction turbines. So cavitation in reaction tubing. So in case of reaction turbine, cavitation may occur at the outlet of the runner. Outlet of the runner or at the inlet of draft tube. So these are the sections where the pressure is low. Now I am drawing a draft tube. So pipe gradually increasing cross section. So this is the tail race. Then this height Z1. So this is the outlet of draft tube. And this is the inlet of draft tube. So outlet of draft tube and inlet of draft tube. Now this is being taken as the reference line, the tail race. So AA is the reference section. So applying Bernoulli's equation at inlet to draft tube and outlet to the draft tube. That is at inlet to the draft tube. Inlet to the draft tube. We know that P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus z is the equation. So at inlet to the draft tube, the pressure will be minimum. So it's the minimum pressure. So P minimum by rho g plus V square by 2g velocity head plus z is equal to P A by rho g plus, here the velocity at outlet is very small compared to the velocity at inlet in case of draft tube, so it is being taken as 0, plus this is the reference datum, reference line AA, so z is equal to 0 plus the losses at F. So this is P minimum, so minimum pressure at inlet, then V square by 2g plus z. So z is the height between the tail race to the runner or at the inlet of the draft tube. Then PA, because the water is being discharged to atmosphere. So PA by rho g plus velocity is very small compared to velocity at inlet. So 0 plus, again 0, the datum is the reference line plus loss. So this can be written as P minimum by rho g is equal to PA by rho g minus V square by 2g plus z plus HF. Then this can be again written as P minimum by rho g is equal to P A by rho g minus V square by 2g minus z plus HF. Now rearranging this equation, we will get V square by 2g minus HF is equal to P A by rho g minus P minimum by rho g minus z. And this term V square by 2g minus HF is a function of head across runner and can be written as sigma c into h. Sigma c into h. So this term is sigma c into h. Therefore, sigma c is equal to PA by rho g minus P minimum by rho g minus z divided by h, where sigma c is the critical cavitation parameter. Critical cavitation parameter. So again, another term, Thomas cavitation factor. So in order to determine whether cavitation will occur in any portion of a reaction turbine, the critical value of Thomas cavitation factor is calculated, and it is being represented by sigma. The Thomas cavitation factor. Sigma. So modifying this critical cavitation parameter, you will get Thomas cavitation factor sigma, which is equal to PA by rho g minus vapor pressure PV by rho g minus z by h. So this can be written in another form. Sigma is equal to h atmospheric minus HV minus HS by H. So this is the atmospheric pressure head, this is the vapor pressure head, capital H is the net head, and HS is the height of turbine runner above the tail rise. We represented it by Z. So if HS can be also be written. So from this figure, Z or HS. So next, cavitation in centrifugal pump. Cavitation in centrifugal pump. In case of centrifugal pumps, the cavitation may occur at the inlet of the impeller of the pump or at the suction side of the pump, where the pressure is considerably low. So due to cavitation, there will be sudden drop in efficiency and head in case of a centrifugal pump. And in order to determine whether cavitation will occur in any portion of the suction side of the pump, the critical value of Thomas cavitation factor is calculated. And the Thomas cavitation factor for centrifugal pump, sigma is equal to H atmospheric minus HV minus HS minus HLS divided by H. So this is atmospheric pressure head, this is vapor pressure head, this is the suction pressure head, HLS is the head loss due to friction in suction pipe, and H is the head developed by the pump. And in order to avoid cavitation, sigma must be greater than sigma c. That is, Thomas cavitation factor must be greater than critical cavitation parameter. Okay.